Hola niños, esta es la segunda parte. This is the second part of the video that we were watching and we were learning about the building beavers. Estamos aprendiendo solo sobre los castores y cómo ellos están construyendo y también cómo ellos son. Vamos a seguir el cuento. Al igual que todos los castores, esta cría puede mantener los ojos abiertos debajo del agua. The last part that we had just read, we read that beavers, after a week of being born, they can swim out on their own. Now we're listening and we're hearing that they can open their eyes underwater. So la última vez que leímos, leímos que los castores, después de una semana nacido, ellos pueden irse nadando. Ahora estamos leyendo que ellos pueden abrir sus ojos. Unos párpados transparentes le cubren los ojos cuando nada. So they have a special covering that goes over their eye. Not glasses, but it's like glasses. They can still see through it. Esta cría está cansada de nadar. Viaja en la cola de su madre. So this baby beaver is tired from traveling, and it's traveling on its mama's tail. Esta madre y su cría se están aciclando. El aciclamiento les mantiene ordenada y limpia la piel. Los castores se peinan con las patas traseras. So at this part, they're going through a certain cycle where they clean themselves and they clean using their back feet, and kind of similar the way a cat does, where you see them licking their paws and sometimes they even rub their paw over their fur. And this is what beavers do to take care of themselves too. Los castores se suavizan la piel con el aceite de su cuerpo. So they soften their fur or any skin that they have by using the oil that the body produces, that it already has. Este aceite no deja que el agua se les meta en la piel. So the special oil stops the water from getting into their skin. A medida que una cría crece, aprende a arreglar los huecos de los diques. So, as a baby beaver grows, they learn how to help fix any of the parts of the dam or the, yes, and the den itself if it breaks apart. Pronto, la cría será un gran constructor como sus padres. And soon, the baby, it's young, is going to also be a building beaver, a great building beaver, like its parents. Busca en esta mapa su estado o tu provincia. ¿Hay castores cerca de tu casa? So, on this map, they're showing us where beavers live. I'm going to make a close-up here. And if you notice, and they're asking, how about where you live? Are there beavers there? And if you see all those little red kind of marks there, that's telling us. This says clave. Clave in English is a key. Muestra donde viven los castores. And here's Texas right there, right above Mexico. Okay. So they live very close. And yes, they do live here in Texas. If I look at Mexico, that's right under, they don't really have beavers. No los tienen aquí. Maybe along the way, the little ridge, but that's just about it. And they go all over the United States of America. If I look here, there's some parts that really don't have them. Okay. Now, if we look here, si miramos aquí, aquí tenemos partes del cuerpo de un castor. And we're going to look at the body parts. And for this week, for science also, if you want to draw, si quieres dibujar, a beaver, and try what we call labeling, eticar, the different parts of a beaver's body. So if I look here, piel, it's fur, oreja, ears, ojo, eyes, hocico, that's its mouth, dientes, his teeth, pata delantera, his front paws, garra, his nails, pata trasera palmeada, his palmed back feet, cola, her tail. Okay. Muchas gracias, niños. Thank you for listening. This is a great story to learn about beavers. Es un cuento muy bueno para aprender sobre los castores.